thing about Thruxton is I think it's a circuit that rewards bravery, but tidiness as well. It's very easy to overdrive sector one and sector three in the chicanes.
Past the start and finish line, just hooking up sort of fifth gear just as you start to turn in. You've got to get your line right there. Obviously, it's quite quick. Try not to hit the curb because, again, it sends the car out a little bit wider than it should do.
Pick your right line, your foot's to the floor. Keep it tight on the left-hand side and flick it into that first one down to third gear.
And then you're braking the last possible minute for the complex, the right, left, right.
Mate, it's really important to slow the car down properly or you end up just pushing yourself really far wide, but you want to connect all the pieces together. So when you come out of the final right, you want to be on the power and have a clean exit so you can get a good run down one of the first straights you get to.
You're on to probably what is one of the longest sections of any circuit in the UK, albeit it's not a straight, it's just continually turning.
Well, the fun cap's a well-planted car, right? So you're kind of coming through that left-hander and it's quick, but it's gripping and you're pretty much flat out.
Sector two in a fun cup car is pretty much flat, but it's also like threading the eye of a needle. So if you get the lines wrong and you have to lift at all, then you're just a sitting duck to all the other cars that are behind you.
A lot of people tend to turn in a bit early there, sort of go for the first apex. But if you sort of stay a little bit wider, I find that if you get to the second apex, it sets you up around for the next section. So you've got basically almost three, maybe even four lanes of tarmac. You've got sort of the older tarmac, part of the old tarmac going into new and vice versa, and it sort of works its way across, and it's a good reference point, really.
You can do that corner flat out, but if you do it flat out, I think you just start scrubbing on the front end. You push yourself out so far wide that you lose all your momentum. You take a wide line, so a little gentle lift into there, keep the car nice and balanced.
You're having to kind of really feather that pedal just a bit, because if you touch that curb, it spits you out left and you're going to be seeing that grass pretty quickly. If you get it right, you can really carry some speed down that hill.
Church is pretty easy flat in a fun cup car. We've got a long straight and a lot of opportunity for drafting.
I've looked at the data and I think you can get about 6 km/h more from a good slipstream. And that was about 10, 20 car lengths back. So it's going to make a massive difference tomorrow. I think there's going to be a lot of good overtaking opportunities into the top end of the circuit.
We've been sort of 3-4 cars side by side in testing, and that's great until you come to the final chicane. It's super important to get nice and neatly into that chicane, because if you don't, again, you're a sitting duck as you go over the start finish line.
Getting into that final chicane is going to be busy. I think the remit for me is going to be stay out of trouble as much as you possibly can. The ideal line for us into that is to stay wide left and flick it in at speed. But of course, that opens you up. Ideal line and what's going to happen in the race may be quite different.
The actual overtaking opportunity into that final chicane, it's not as easy as it looks, because the way you go across the circuit, you almost straight line across the circuit. So it looks like there's a gap initially, and all of a sudden it just closes up. And it's a very, very tight chicane, the slowest part of the circuit for sure.
Choice of 15 lines. Depends who's in front of you, what side of you, or whatever. But again, try and brake as late as you can, straight as you can, but not to rush the entry, because if you turn in and sort of have a little bit of a scrub on the right-hander, you're not going to hook it up for the left and back onto the start-finish straight.
One of those where you've got to get the car stopped and then rotate it early so you can drive really out of the last two parts of the corner. Super critical to a quick lap.
It's a relatively easy track, but you've got to hang on, you've got to position the car right, because if you miss, say, a turning in point by maybe a foot, you're 3 foot, 4 foot, the other side, so you've got to be fairly accurate. But yeah, love it, it's good fun.